initially written. Now if you pick up Coco Fly, you see it has just one ingredient. And the only one it's got is 100% pure coconut water. So I love having it. It hydrates me. The pH of coconut water is very close to our blood. So what happens is that it instantly hydrates you. Yeah, so that's, I mean, I love Coco Fly because of all of these reasons, and it's super convenient, so you guys can definitely
put it. Rashi lives in Dubai, and I follow her food plan. And every time she'd be like, just have the coconut water, just have almond milk, and then she'd post these pictures of these amazing packaging, and she says these are like almost 100%. I'm like, we don't get them here, so if you want me to have it, send it. So now I don't need to
send it. Coconut
water is perfect. Okay, Rashi, I just want to ask you, what are the three most common myths around dieting?
Oh my god. Yes, please. Thank you for asking. Okay, so you said three, yeah. So the first one here would be... stick to three, don't worry. Okay, the first one is, which I hear from a lot of you guys, is that fat makes you fat. Now, I want you to understand this concept really, really well, that eating fat does not make you fat. Sometimes when I sit with my clients one-on-one, I actually increase the consumption to triple.
Yay!
I swear to God, and this is not
true. I did recently. I had pasteurized butter, and then look what happened.
And she had it on fat. You actually dropped fat.
No, ask her what she had the pasteurized butter on.
What was it on?
Bread.
Yeah. So that's a recipe for disaster, okay? But hear me out. So listen, most of the hormones in our body, 80% of them are made from fat. This is not my opinion, it's just science. So if you want to be hormonally healthy, you have to increase the amount of fat you actually consume. Alright, so that's number one. Start adding ghee, butter, coconut oil, but don't do what she did. If you're going to take bread, and you're going to have...
That's a perfect example.
I'm glad you mentioned that, you know, because if you're going to have butter on top of bread, then that's not the best combination.
In 3 days.
Based on?
3 days of that.
That's not bad. 3 days is nothing. But anyway, the point is that, so please start adding the good fats in your diet. Cut out the bad fat, all right? That's number one. Second thing, okay, which oil do you guys use at home for cooking? What do you guys use?
Rice
bran. Okay, if you're using a vegetable oil, please know it's cheap, it's refined, it's not giving you anything. Lastly, it has way too much omega-6. Now, this might be a little complicated, but what I want you to understand is that your body needs a very good ratio or a very delicate ratio of omega-3 to omega-6. We are getting way too much omega-6 than we need from the cooking oil because we eat outside. Outside, no one's going to cook your food in coconut oil. It's going to be in regular cheap oil. So we're getting too much omega-6, which is why most women nowadays have PCOD, or a lot of people have thyroid. All these are inflammation disorders, all right? So start cooking in ghee, butter, coconut oil, mustard oil. These are your best bets. And lastly, I'd say, fruit juices, whether they are fresh or they are packaged, I'm sorry, but take it from a diabetic expert, diabetic educator, it is nothing but liquid candy, alright? The effect that a glass of even fresh orange juice has on your blood sugar levels is as good as having 3 tablespoons of chini. It's the same thing. You can't eat 4 oranges at one time, but you can drink them easily, alright? So it's no good. Fruit juice is something you don't need to juice your fruits, just eat them how they're supposed to be eaten.
If you allow us.
I think it depends on your fitness level. Yeah.
And your activity. And I think our MC is learning the most today. You have seen her face. Please look at the expression every time one of us says something. She's like, that's why she stood on the scale and the fat percentage was so high, because she is a cheater.
I am. I love sugar and I love everything fried. So a nightmare for all three of us.
Check your lipid profile as well. Just throwing it in there.
Okay, let's stop talking about me. It's a tattoo now, Rowena. Okay, so people on diets often feel like they've been sent on a prison sentence. I say yes. So give us some tips on how to make food fun and not just something that's bland, boring, or you know, oh, I can only eat this much.
Okay, the first thing I'd like to say is when anyone is sitting and says, okay, you have to go on a diet, I think the first thing one thinks of is, oh my god, I have to have boring steamed vegetables and salads full of leaves. So that's your misconception here, because even a simple thing like a salad, you can make it so delicious. You got to add your protein to it, which your nutritionist will tell you that you need to have protein. So you add some chickpeas, some red kidney beans, or some pearl barley, and you spruce it up and you make your salad absolutely delicious. So you want to eat it, you look forward to that salad. You don't say, oh my god, I'm just going to open a bowl of leaves and I don't want to eat this. But you're going to have so many options to play with. And secondly, the ingredients that you use, let's say you have fussy kids, you know, and you really want to feed them and you want to give them fiber and nutrition. And let's take a simple thing that you would see in our recipe book here. We have a recipe for a brownie. And if you give a child a piece of brownie, he's going to eat it without even thinking twice. But the brownie here is made completely out of sweet potato. It has nothing wrong in it. It's a gluten-free brownie. It has dates and agave nectar honey for sweetening and a little bit of rocacoa. And it is so delicious, but the child doesn't know what's in it, or you, even a fussy eater, wouldn't know what's in it, but you eat it and it's so delicious. And what you've done is given your body the absolute nutrition that you need without eating any refined sugar and still taking care of your sweet tooth, and you know, you've made food fun for yourself. So that's the idea, that's how I would say it. Don't make it sound like it's a sentence for you, but it's absolutely a fun thing to try out and make it your lifestyle. Don't call it a diet, it's like your lifestyle. You just do this on a regular basis. You just choose the right ingredients. You know, don't even know what's the wrong stuff anymore because you always stack the right stuff at home.
So I actually tried the brownie that she's talking about, the sweet potato brownie.
Oh my god.
It was really, really good, and you couldn't tell. You just couldn't tell.
All right, so I'm looking forward to trying that. I could change.
You can open your fridge every day and look for it.
So how many brownies can one have
in it? If it's sweet potato and dates and all of the stuff that you're saying, then you can have like four as a quick snack.
Wow.
How big are they? So I know what the brownie looks like, right? I know in my mind.
All the brownies like that you have.
Yeah, exactly.
That's worth thinking brownie.
Like, yeah, a nice proper brownie.
No, so my bad, because I had it yesterday, so I know exactly what they look like. Oh, but the recipe is in the book.
Yeah,
there's a recipe.
Where's the book?
Yeah.
I need that.
Yeah.
Come on,
yeah.
You have to make it for us.
I shall.
Rubina's
still making my hummus.
But have it as a snack, okay? The worst thing you can do is have it as a dessert after your full meal. Don't do that.
I think it's just something that you mean four snacks a day.
I mean one snack of four of your evenings.
four
of the pieces that she gave me yesterday.
Listen, more brownies.
She's gonna make her life with a candy.
It's okay, I'm ready to have your
money. Okay.
She deserves it. Because she's fit. Be fit because you deserve it. Get hell because you deserve it.
Okay, yeah, so now I'm gonna come to you.
Yes.
So there's a lot of people that struggle to find time to work out. Life is very hectic. And yeah. So I know that my shoes have been in your gym since October, which is when I had my last workout. I'm coming tomorrow.
I mean, you know, I follow you on Twitter and Instagram and all the social media. I know exactly what you're up to. When you say you don't have time, so I'm quite a stalker
Stop it!
I was traveling. You know, I went to these places.
But I was.
Okay, yeah.
Okay.
So that is something
coming back.
That everyone says, I don't have time to work out. And like I started earlier, it's the commitment. If you've made the commitment and you want to be true to it, you will make time to work out. And honestly, if you don't have time for a full 1 hour workout, break it up. You see, all of us, we wear something called the jaw bone. We're not advertising for it, but we all wear it, and even auntie's wearing it. And it just counts your step. So you make a target of say 5,000, 6,000 steps a day. So whatever else you do, you make sure you complete your steps. All your phones now are smartphones, I'm sure, because all of you sitting here look pretty smart to me. It has different apps to count your steps. There's a Nike Plus app, there's different things. And so monitor the amount of steps you do. You can break your 1 hour of workout that you need in a day to 5 minutes, 10 times a day. You know, it can just be 5 very quick things that you do maybe 5 times a day. And you don't need to find that 1 hour, you know. So when you don't have time, plus, all of us have mobiles. I'm sure all of you have mobiles here. Raise your hands, all those who don't have mobiles. So when I'm having a 1 hour gossip session with my best friend about how that girl that I went to the party really irritated me because she was eyeing my husband. She was so damn good looking and hot that he was paying me no attention. Vicious. And looking, why am I not walking while you're talking? Just walk around the room while you talk on the phone. Why do you have to be glued to a chair when the three of us are standing and moving and burning some calories, you know? So men, women, humans come from the animal world. We're animals, and animals are meant to move. Our lives have become so sedentary that we get down in the lift, our car is waiting at the porch. We don't even want to walk to the car because we've told the driver the night before, "Jab main niche aungi, meri gaadi udhar chahiye." So we've called the driver when we're getting into the lift and said, "Main niche aa rahi hu, gaadi taiyar rakho." You know, we want a glass of water, we call Ramu, pani dao. Okay, we don't do any work. We don't move. Of course, it's too hot in Bombay to park your car far away and walk to the car, or if you're living on the 30th floor to walk up the stairs. But you can get off on the 25th floor and walk up 5 stories of stairs, you know, to make sure you get some movement in the day. My best thing is walking when I'm talking. Not right now, but normally. Because you burn calories, you're moving, you know. You have so many expressions because you're just, and he was looking at her. So your arms are moving, you know, you're getting a full body movement. Not workout, because to work it out, you would have to have some weight bearing. But you can even, while talking, put it on speaker, go to your table, do some table push-ups, sit on your chair, do some tricep dips. There are lots of exercises you can do while talking on the phone. So, you know, that's what I'd say. There's never not enough time to move.
Alright, so what is the minimum amount of time that you think one should devote in a week, let's say?
To be healthy?
Yeah, to be healthy and fit.
At least 30 minutes a day to be healthy. To be fit depends on what your current fitness level is. And again, one rule does not work for everyone. So I would just say to be healthy, to have good digestion, to, you know, not have problems. 30 minutes a day is the minimum you should be doing. If you want to be fit, if you want to look like Sophie Chowdhury or Deepika Padukone, I don't mean look exactly, but be as slim as them, then it depends where you are right now and what you have to do to get there.
All right, thank you. And Sophie, you've got a very, very hectic schedule, I know. But then I also stalk you on social media. And you are constantly working out. How do you find the time to balance those two? And how do you look like you do?
Thank you. I think some of you guys can't see me, Sastan. You know, actually, I just think that the most important thing is to change your lifestyle and make it a lifestyle. So I don't look at working out like a chore. If I don't do a session of Pilates or if I don't do any movement in the day, I'm miserable. And it's not because I want to be thin and I want to fit into that super tight Hervé Léger dress or anything like that. It's I, within myself, don't feel good. I don't feel positive if I do not work out or do not do some form of exercise. When it comes to food, perhaps I'm fortunate that I generally enjoy healthy food, but again, I don't think of it as a diet. In fact, when I met Rashi, the first thing I said to her is, "I've never done a diet in my life," and it's true. I do not diet. I do not deprive myself of anything, but I maintain a basic healthy lifestyle. I think we all know what's good for us and what's not good for us. It's logic. I don't think you really need somebody to tell you that. You just need to be able to have the strength from within to just take that on. The one thing that I did do when I went to Rashi, I know I drove you crazy, because I didn't really follow too much of what she said, but there is, who reduced the volume? Oh, you can keep it up. I know how to control a mic, thank you. So I think the one thing that I did take away from Rashi, which has changed my life, is I'm somebody who likes desserts. I'm somebody who likes sugar, which I know is hard to believe, but give me anything from a tiramisu to a rasmalai and I will have it. But what I have stopped doing is, the minute I met her, I stopped adding any sugar to any tea or coffee. And I know that all of us have at least one or two teas in a day, or three or four. If you're in Bombay, it's cutting chai, it's this big, so you end up having four or five. Just stop adding sugar and you'll see a huge difference. And another thing that happened is I became gluten-free. And that is a huge change in your life. Now, for people who say things like, I need my roti, believe it or not, in Bombay, you can get gluten-free atta. And we make rotis from that at home now. I generally don't eat Indian food maybe more than once or twice a week. And I know that sounds crazy, but the amount of great food you can have without having all your desi masale and cooked in oil and tons of roti and tons of chawal, it's amazing if you get out there and you explore. The thing is, I don't have to, because I have this incredible mother who goes on the internet every single day and finds a new recipe, be it from Jamie Oliver or whoever, to come up with an exciting, interesting salad. You know, things like grilling a sweet potato. There's so many exciting things you can do, which is what Rowena was talking about, which is what Rashi says, which is what Yaz says. But the most important thing is to not be healthy and crazy healthy for 1 week and then give it up. That's what everybody does. I'm gonna get fit this week, I'm gonna work out every day, I'm gonna eat salads all week, and then you give up. And that's the saddest thing. I think it's better if you're slow and steady and change your lifestyle so that it is your life, rather than saying, I'm gonna get fit next month, so I'll do this for 2 weeks. And then stop, because that's pointless. That's just not gonna achieve you any results. I think the only reason that I kind of am like this is because I'm consistent. I don't diet, I don't work out like crazy 1 week. I am just like this. So I think I pretty much look the same because I'm always like this. And I think that's just the best advice I can give anyone, is to not be extreme. Don't starve yourself, don't deprive yourself. Just try and adopt an overall healthier lifestyle, and trust me, you will be a happier person. More than being thin, and more than, you know, getting into your favorite pair of tight jeans, which is great, it feels great, you will be a much happier person when you eliminate all of those negative things that you're eating, all of those excuses that I don't have time for myself. That's just not true. If it means getting up half an hour earlier, you have to do it. If it means sleeping half an hour later, you have to do it. You have to make time for yourself. And the biggest example I can give of this, and she is by far, Yaz, the most popular client of yours at Yasmin's Body Image. And that is my mom, who used to be, I think, my size right until her 50s. Then, having lived in England for 47 years of her life, and that's where I'm born and brought up, I made her move here because of this crazy dream that I wanted to pursue. Now, when you're in England, you have a very active lifestyle. My mom was doing Pilates 25 years ago with a man who brought Pilates to England. So I was aware of it as a kid. And then you come to Bombay and the same thing, Ramu, Pani Lao, Gadi Lao, Ye Lao, where is there to walk? I think the first, when we moved here, my mom actually broke her leg because she's not used to looking down when she's walking. And everything has a pothole, and what are you supposed to do? So after all of these years, we've been here 10 years now, just over 10 years, it's been 11, 12 years actually now. And I finally convinced my mom to join Yaz. And mom started going to Yaz regularly in end of April. And she lost 16 kilos by October. The reason I'm saying this is because anybody who says, I'm getting older, it's so much harder. Anyone who says, I do not have the time. It's, you know what? If you want to do it, you will do it. And let me tell you, when she's in the gym, everybody who's half her age is feeling motivated and embarrassed because they're like, oh my God, like she's doing this, we need to do this. So I'm just saying that it's a strength and a desire that comes from within. And if you want it, you will do it.
Thank you very much.
And she's a very tough cookie to please, Auntie, because she's done Pilates with the person who brought Pilates to London straight from Joseph Pilates. And when she's in the gym, actually, Sophie and I are a little at attention so that we don't make any mistakes. And her dedication and, you know, just overcoming all her different problems, and there's not a day that, you know, she, and she says that, oh, I'm not feeling well, because she said, you know, today I'll do it a little lightly because I'm not feeling up to it. But she's there, and she's not just a mother who's sitting at home and you know, looking for recipes for Sophie and cooking for her. She is her manager. So she does all of managing Sophie and all the other things, and makes time for herself to come and work out. And I think she deserves a round of applause. Yay!
Okay, so everybody stood up, and I think I should do now.
Finally! Woohoo! You're an animal now.
This is the coolest gig I've ever gotten to host. Because the gig, you know, usually has the host standing, and the guest sitting down, the speaker sitting down, and the role was reversed, and this is after... Like,
because it's a fitness.
It's amazing!
And you can only be fit if you deserve it.
Yes. So I'm going to keep walking because I deserve it. And now I'm going to ask you guys, do you have any questions for our experts over here? Any questions?
I have a question.
Yeah.
You just said that you shouldn't have the butter with the bread. And what do you have?
So, well, like I said, it depends a lot on what you're, where you are currently at your fitness level, what you're trying to get at. Which is why when she talks about commitment and all of that, there needs to be some goal you're trying to reach at. So it depends. Why don't you tell me what your goal is right now?
My goal is just to maintain where I am. And
then, one of the changes you will make is just start cooking your food in ghee, coconut oil or butter. If you were someone who was struggling with weight and you were just stuck with stubborn weight and just not losing it, then I would recommend wake up in the morning, have a tablespoon of ghee or butter and start your day like that. But since that's not one of your goals, just make sure you start cooking in better, you know, medium or fat.
So if I have to have butter in the morning?
You
don't have to. Yeah, but if I want to, I want
okay,
to.
Okay, so I'll tell you. So generally, this whole butter concept comes...
I want butter also.
If you can't do pasteurized, unsalted butter, ideally I do pasteurized, unsalted.
Have unsalted.
You have unsalted. Yeah, so then what you can do, again, this is not, like I said,
and
everyone
I used to
has
not have it before. But it's just because I go to Yas so regularly. I've been there for the last 13 years.
Right.
So now it's every time all the tips come up. So you start with, okay, a little bit fat in the morning.
Right. So let me put this
to yours only.
Yeah, fat in the morning works beautifully for people, one who are just not losing weight. You know, there are some who are metabolically deranged. What that means is you have thyroid, you have PCOD, you have endometriosis, you know, you're diabetic. And you have extra weight to lose, and no matter what you do, have you had clients like this? No matter what they do, no matter what workout they do, they just don't drop weight. That is because you're metabolically deranged. So what you will do for 2 weeks, you're going to go completely on a different tangent. What I do with my clients is they wake up and they have a tablespoon of butter blended in black coffee. Now this sounds insane, but it works like, I know, the face that you're making, right? Okay, if you blend it, then it tastes
like cappuccino.
But a fake cappuccino, because obviously there's no lactose in it. Butter does have lactose, very little. So when you blend it like that and have it, after a couple of days, you will want it. Simple. Because your brain starts functioning better, you have lesser cravings, you're going to be fuller for longer. Having said that, a lot of people, not a lot, say 20% of my clients don't respond well to it. So then we change it. Then they do a tablespoon of ghee in the morning. But like I said, it depends on where you are at your current fitness level and what you're aiming towards. So yeah.
So how does one determine your current fitness level?
Okay, one. Are you happy when you wake up every morning? Are you happy with the body you have? If you don't have it, then it's time to make a change. Because if you're not feeling good about yourself, what is the point? That's one. Second thing, when you're climbing steps, are you able to climb them, you know, normally? Otherwise, generally I tell people, do a 5K. See how long it takes you. If it's going to take you more than 10 minutes to do 1 kilometer, then you're just in really bad, like you're really in a bad...
No, I'd say 12 minutes.
12?
10
really?
Is for a fit person, yeah.
So for 5K or
1K?
For
1K. 12. Do a 5K doing 1 kilometer for 10 minutes. In 10 minutes, which I think is average, but you have to give a leeway to people
that's your forte. So obviously, that's how a judge, but for me, I want to wake up every morning and feel good about my body.
you know, I want to feel good, I want to feel like I'm looking good and feeling good and all of that. If you're not feeling like that, then it's time to change.
So what if you're looking really good?
But and you're feeling good.
And you're feeling wonderful and you're looking good. But when you climb up the steps, you're breathless.
Yeah, so then clearly that it's time to change. Then you're not fit, so then it's time to change, exactly.
What if I'm looking good and I'm feeling good, but I don't want to get up, I want to sleep somewhere?
Yeah, we did. Oh, yes.
That won't happen.
I never want to wake up in the morning.
I don't believe that, yes.
She gets a lot of people like that.
Any more questions? Yes.
What's a good substitute for butter? A person stubborn fat, aging.
If you can't
and you have all the problems, that age related problems.
Yeah.
But still you want to have butter on bread.
Is this for you?
Yeah.
Okay. So you should
I think
if you're bloated, then you need fat. Yeah, but then stubborn fat is just it's not the right. No, I think you should start with a tablespoon of coconut oil.
On bread?
No. If you're going to mix your carbs, if you're going to mix,
you have to give up bread.
Exactly. Not everyone needs to give up bread.
Initially.
Not everyone,
initially.
But it depends. If you're saying you have stubborn fat, then you need to make drastic changes to shock your body a bit.
Try gluten-free bread. Gluten-free bread, that'll help you. Where do you get anywhere in
market? Nature's Basket.
Nature's Basket has it freely available.
Just have bajra roti and jamar roti.
Substitute your wheat. Delete your wheat from.
You should be wheat.
If you're a bread lover, trust me, you won't like gluten-free bread. It's kadak. What I do is I piso brown rice. Now you get brown rice atta, and I make rotis out of brown rice. So.
Yeah.
That really works.
Yeah.
Brown rice.
Maybe your stubborn fat is because you're very stubborn about liking bread.
Yeah.
You should change your mindset. I think you've eaten bread for enough years of your life. It's time to make a change. You have to either give up the fat or the bread. Make your choices, like I said initially.
Well, I buy varieties of bread.
Varieties.
Any other questions?
Yeah.
I'll come back to you guys.
So I recently underwent a surgery for my
spotlight,
and I had like really bad issues right from my hand and everything. But now I have like belly fat, which I can't do crunches. I can't do crunches or anything anymore.
Okay, so her question is, wow, this is really good. After talks about me. So her question is, she underwent a surgery, she has some cervical spondylosis problem, and because of that, she's developed belly fat. I think we need to review what you're eating, what your activity is, because seriously, if you do crunches till the cows come home only, you're not going to lose that belly fat. Belly fat has nothing to do with doing abdominal exercises. It's lifestyle, it's what you eat, it's what your fitness level is. It's a combination of fitness, food, and nutrition. So a consult with all three of us would be a good idea. I'm totally selling it right now.
A lot of people go to gyms or trainers saying, I need to lose weight only from my hips, or I need to lose weight only from my arms, or it's basically people believe in spot reduction. But I think, you know, there's a lot of people who come, I mean, I've done this with you, I want to lose weight, but I don't want to lose weight on my face. Yeah, that's just unrealistic. It's just not going to happen. And if anybody thinks that only by doing hip exercises, you'll get better hips, or if only by doing arms, you'll get better arms, it doesn't happen. It has to start with your food. And I really believe that how you look is at least, I mean, the workout is usually important, but 70% is what you put in, right? Sorry, guys, I know that working out is hugely important.
Yeah,
I totally
believe in that as well. And like she said, I have people who say, I want to lose weight, but I don't want my face to go because the charm goes. I have some Sindhi women who come and they say, I want to lose weight, and they're doing beautiful.
ब्यूटिफुली टिल वन आंटी हू हैज कम विद देम एंड सेड इतनी वीक हो गई है देन द नेक्स्ट टाइम दे कम टू क्लास दे पुट ऑन 5 किलोस एंड सी हैज पुट ऑन 5 किलोस द पर्सन लाफिंग द लाउडेस्ट इज द वन विद दैट एग्जांपल दैट कारण रियली व्हाट it's a combination of the three so maybe you're working out and you know you're doing everything else and if you actually review what you're eating and what kind of workouts you're doing you'll find the answer yourself because you're smart
but then when you meet people sabse pehle ye kahenge bade pull down lag raha hai aap instead of saying you're looking good
आपको कोई आपको पता नहीं है पुल डाउन क्या है पुल अप आप अपने आप को पुल अप करो cheeky answer to someone like that so they won't say that again to you and then just you're happy with the way you look or I get people who say I'm fine but I just want to lose weight on my face when I take pictures my face looks very chubby so I send them to my friend who's a makeup artist and I say learn how to contour
Alright, the girls in the back had a question.
What's with the no carbs after sunset? Like, how do you live like that?
How do you live
without carbs after sunset? Wow.
So, well, everyone does not need to not eat carbs after sunset. But if you're training in the evening, if you're working out in the evening, then definitely push in some carbs in the evening. But not for everyone, you know. What is it that you're looking for?
The thing is, if I have a light meal, like it's not carbohydrate, like then the morning.
You understand, fruits and vegetables have carbohydrates as well.
Yeah, exactly.
You know that.
Exactly.
Yes.
That's
okay.
The only thing I end up having, like fruits and vegetables at night. Then I drop weight in the morning, and.
But you're still having your carb because you are
exactly
have.
So exactly. So you can't have roti sabzi like later on.
No, but you cannot eat fruit and vegetable for dinner. You cannot do
no,
that. You will not lose weight.
Yeah, okay. That's the thing. I'm not losing weight with that.
But you just said you wake up in the morning and your scale is.
Yeah, it's
so
a little
one
bit.
First thing is you throw your scale. Okay,
exactly.
Throw
that's
the damn scale.
Yes.
Second thing is when you're eating to lose weight. All right, you've got to be smart with your macros. When I say macros, means your carb, protein, fat. These are your macros. What you've done is only eaten carbs at night. So forget about weight loss. I don't know your body completely, but what I would recommend generically is you do protein and fat at night. So you're better off having, I don't know, eggs with avocado or let's say dal with sabzi. That also has carbs, but at least there's protein and fat in it as well. Or chicken and veggies, I don't know. Are you vegetarian?
No, I said chicken.
You had chicken, yeah? So chicken and vegetables is perfect. That's way better than having just fruit and God, salad, yeah.
You had a question, yeah.
Every day we are bombarded with different kinds of fitness regime, diets and everything. So what to follow and what to not? Like you are telling a completely different thing as per the diet.
Right.
And when we go through internet or the television and when we go through newspapers, every day there's a new funda for diet, fitness and workouts, different kinds of workouts.
See,
so
it is very, very confusing. I agree. There are some people who say go by calories, some people say no, some people say cut your portions out. I think it's what's important is you understand your body, you know. Like again, first fix a goal. What is your goal? You have to fix a goal, alright, that this is how much I want to lose and please not weight. It's got to be body fat percent, alright, that's one. Now if you have, for example, you go get your body fat percentage done and your muscle is very low, for most Indian women, okay, most of you, if you do your analysis, your muscle mass is going to be low, that's for sure. I don't know how you have 27 kgs of muscle on you. Obviously, how means you've obviously been training for so long, which is
now
why.
It's become 26 with my knee broken.
It's okay, you'd build it back up. Yeah, but if you're low on muscle but high on fat, which is pretty much a lot of us here, then you have to increase your protein. So you'll have to eat more dal, more chicken, more, you know, fish, more eggs, more all of that. So you have to understand your body. Not everyone is going to be successful on a gluten-free plan. When you eat wheat, does it bloat you? Do you feel tired? Do you feel edgy? If you do, then cut it out for a week and see what you feel like. So understand about it, tune into it, you know.
Also, I know you're fancy, it's confusing, but you know what? I think the best way to judge it is which one can you adopt permanently?
Yeah, and stick with
it. You know, like look at, there's so many things on the internet. If you look at it and you say, you know what, this is not something that I can make my lifestyle, then clearly that diet is not for you.
But
Because what you have to do is you have to follow a food plan that becomes your lifestyle so that you're doing it every day. Yes, when you want to lose a bit of extra weight, you have to push yourself a little bit further, but by and large, you have to eat what you can eat consistently every day. So if you're looking at things and you're just saying, there's no possible way I can do that, then that diet's not for you.
Yeah, but I'll tell you what, the first time I ate sweet potato and avocado, I was like,
say, limit yourself to this many calories in a day. If you cannot function doing that, you don't understand how to do that, that diet is not for you.
Exactly.
Or if there's something that tells you only do protein and nothing else,
exactly.
That's just not feasible. You have to, you know, follow something that's sensible. That's, I think that's the best advice to give you.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? That's extreme. Do a diet of barley water or do a diet of, you know, pineapple
that's
juice. That's all ridiculous.
Yeah.
None of that is ever going to work. You have to be sensible enough to look at a diet and say, this balances things out in a way that I can deal with,
yeah.
I think, and that's right.
Oh yeah, that's cool.
I think the most important thing is not to Google so much on the internet. Okay, because internet is not Indian bodies only, and every country has a different set of food and a different set of body types and things like that. So it's much better to follow someone in your vicinity. In your area, again in India, there are so many states and every state has different kinds of food. So what, you know, like a diet that we follow in Bombay might not be a diet you follow in Indore or in Chandigarh, you know, the food available is different. So internet is great for a lot of things, but for something as personal as food and exercise, it's very individualistic and your body is your own. It's no one else's. What works for me will not work for you. You know, if I have 27 kgs of fat, muscle, she can't have that even if she starts lifting heavy weights because her body is made up differently. So understand your own body first, okay? Sophie said, find a diet that works for you. Don't find a diet that has everything that you like to eat, which might not be good for you. So be sensible, be smart. All of us have smartphones. I keep coming back to the smartphones, but it's a great example because everyone goes around saying I'm so smart, or you know, or in your mind you're thinking you're smarter than the next person, you know, the person next to you. Then why the hell are you not making, sorry for the language, smart choices in life? If you're smart, make smart workout and food choices for a smarter, healthier, better life.
Any more questions?
Some recipe that you could carry, a quick bite that you could carry to work and keep the energy goes on.
Well, firstly, if you log on to our website, you'll find a million recipes every day, new recipes coming up every day. But the best thing to do is have fun with your food, like I said before, and be prepared so you can make like hummus or avocado butter and keep it in your fridge stocked up. So if you just cut out a few vegetables, throw a dollop of that, carry a little bit of your brown rice. Every day you have a different lunchbox idea. You can whip up salads and, you know, things that make it interesting. And choose your vegetables with color. Everything that has color is really, really good for you. You know, the darker the color is, the better it is. So you fill up your box with colorful veggies and you look at it and it looks so good when you open it in your lunch break and, you know, you had a horrible boss and he's yelling at you and you suddenly open up the box like, oh my God, like I have this yummy meal to go to. So you keep yourself prepared like that. And another thing that she said is about movement. When you're talking on the phone, you're moving around. You do it on the weekend. You go to a farmer's market. You look at these amazing vegetables. You move your body to find your food on the weekend. So the whole week is prepared for. You have your stuff ready, you know, stacked up. You know what you're going to cook. And you're going to have fun with your entire, you know, health regime. So, thank you so much. Yeah.
Is avocado fruit or vegetable?
Fruit.
It's the butter good?
Of course, the avocado butter is the most delicious thing you can ever have.
Yeah, so has it got a lot of fat?
Listen, so avocados is one thing you have to include if you're struggling with stubborn weight or you have PCOD, any of those things. Because like I said, that's the kind of fat that makes the hormones inside your body. You want to be hormonally healthy all the time. Yeah, so you have to add avocado or butter or I don't know, nut butters.
She knows this better probably, but a Mars bar, a chocolate Mars bar, has the exact same amount of calories that you would find in an avocado, okay?
But what you're eating in that avocado, it's like having that ghee or the coconut oil in the morning. You're giving your body the best that you can. You're going to glow, you're going to look good, you're going to lose that fat because you're eating that right thing. You're not eating that chocolate bar that's going to give you pimples and you're going to look horrible and you're going to put on weight. But with this avocado, you're going to lose weight, you're going to eat the right stuff, and yet you're eating the exact amount of calories that your dietitian is telling you to eat. So you're just right on track if you eat an avocado.
So it's a good substitute for butter.
It is, absolutely. It's a good substitute.
What about white rice?
Okay, white rice depends a lot on your digestive tract. So a lot of my clients who don't respond well to wheat, we do white rice. White rice actually is very alkaline. So if you're someone who's struggling with any inflammatory disorders, you must include white rice over gluten products. So like get your chapati out, get your bread out, and replace it with white rice. Even my diabetic clients, I'll give them white rice, but then I'll make them put a tablespoon of ghee on it. Because that way their sugar level won't shoot up. Otherwise white rice will always shoot your sugar level up. So you always add some good fat in it.
Like Indian diet has rice, roti, dal.
Huh.
So then you have to cut out on your roti and just eat the rice?
You're not going to have rice and roti together. I'm sorry. That's just not allowed. You cannot. See, their digestive process.
Indian diet, because everybody has roti as well as rice.
Which is all of us.
Together.
But that's not, it doesn't make, scientifically it doesn't make sense. Also, see, you've got to do these things by yourself, right? You've got to try and eliminate
eating
and see how you feel.
Scientifically, it may not.
Agreed.
And like I said, you have to make your choice. Is your choice to eat roti, rice, dal, or is your choice to lose weight and get fitter? If your choice is to eat it and, you know, whatever, then that's your choice.
Can I ask you, I have a question.
Because we're in India, and like we were saying, even on the internet, it doesn't address a lot of Indian issues. So from both of you, because you're talking about food and nutrition, three food items, each of you, that Indians must absolutely eliminate from their diet. Like three food items that they... Yeah, they must eliminate. Because they're three... No, yeah, as opposed to add, but they must absolutely eliminate because they're always go-to things that they just should completely avoid.
Sugar,
and sugar. Don't even look at sugar. Like anything white, sugar, fine sugar, maida, anything. Yeah, flour. Anything that's white. In my kitchen, there's nothing white. You will not find anything white. You have to find a substitute for it. You can again look.
Paneer.
I would say eat soya paneer because again it's made from milk. But that depends on what suits you. And when I'm saying white, I mean to say like as an ingredient which comes in a thing, like a sugar, a spoon of sugar, which is so natural for any Indian home to just say, you know, shakkar dalo, chini dalo. It's like so easy. But there are so many other things. You can use dates, you can use natural fruits for sugar, you can use anything else rather than, you
honey.
Know, honey, agave, you know, raw honey. And you know, there are a lot of options that you can choose, but you just like... All of them have said here, if you try reducing your sugar for even a week, you will feel the difference in your body. Let alone look about it, you will feel more energetic because that's what's killing you, according to me. So she knows better.
Well, I'd like
to in. Just type pea protein, you get brown rice protein, you get hemp protein, all of this. You get hemp here. And pea is the best. And then take the amount of protein that you need in a meal. That is the amount of protein that you need to consume, and this is pure protein. So it doesn't even take that much time to digest. So at one time, Rashi, this is my question to you. What is a good amount of protein that you can take at one time?
There's a lot of research that shows it should be below 25 grams. And above 25, your body can't really digest. But unless you've gone for a crazy workout, you've lifted a lot, then maybe a little more.
If you've done like a Arnold Schwarzenegger or Salman Khan kind of workout.
Which
none
of us do. Exactly.
One other tiny thing, I just
want to
say, because everyone...
We all get the munchies around 5:30. I think that's the toughest time for everybody. That 5:30 chai, coffee, or uske saath kya. That's when all those cheese toasts and all those bhels and all those soya chaklis that you think are healthy, that's when all of those things come out. So 5:30 munchies, what can you suggest that's healthy for people? You know, just easy and you know, healthy and
available.
And available.
Well, I would, you know, on a, you can add, but what I would do is, now this meal has to be a combination of carb, protein and fat, because that will keep you full. So I would take an avocado, add smashed dates in it, add raw cacao in it, maybe throw some walnuts and mix it up.
Rashi, these women are not going to do that. Yeah. Give us something that they will have. Yeah.
Okay, so then I'll tell you what, take a bowl, make these little jars. If you're on the go, take a little bit of muesli, add some nuts in it and keep that with you so you can have that. Or you make energy bites. Take some smashed dates, put raw cacao in it, put sesame seeds in it. Make these little balls and carry them with you. But
something that's grab and go. Something that's grab and go. Like, I know, like, she has a, yeah, so she has, like, a, the protein bake shop. So she does these really cool truffles that mom and I have every day at 5:30
with
our
chai. These truffles are meant for fat. Like, they're meant for weight loss.
But I'm saying, you know, people want something that's yummy. At that time, 5:30, otherwise you will eat that healthy thing and you will still go for the yummy thing.
So you
can eat something yummy that's healthy. So we do like roasted makhanas, which I think are fine.
You have to, for something like that, I think.
Makhanas
are great. You can do and for something like that, you need to be prepared. So you keep it ready in your, you know, you stack it like how you buy cookies. So you take a little time and you make like a batch of roasted makhana with some nice masala, whatever you like, chaat masala, and keep it in your, you know, cupboard. So when you take that cup of tea, you go and fetch for that nice bowl of makhana, or you take, even if you take almond flour and you mix it with a little bit of cocoa and a little bit of honey, you can create really nice fudgy brownies which are there in your fridge. You just pick it out and eat a bite and you feel good about it. So it's so
But wait, listen, sorry. But I swear to God, try this avocado mousse. It's really nice.
No, I believe you, but most people here are not used to even having that in their diet.
Yeah.
And when you're at that 5:30, you just kind of have that yummy
avocados.
You don't get good avocados. Sophie buys the imported avocados,
so
which we cannot afford.
No,
I don't want to invest 800 rupees in one avocado.
What?
Yes.
So please,
they'll come and spend on us to make them lose weight. Yeah. They may as well buy the.
I don't want to spend 800 rupees on avocado.
Just come on, you will.
Just
you
try the brownie recipe in the book. It is with sweet potato and it has.
I like
just
that.
Perfect.
You, the right person, please don't come to Mumbai and tell us supply avocados to us.
Try it.
Come here. Coffee, man. Sit. Ma'am, yeah. Coffee, man. Yeah, look here.
Look here.
Ma'am, yeah.
Look here, look here.
Put your hand down. Rush. What an
ये जो आज इवेंट था इट वॉज गेटिंग फिट विद अ फैबुलस थ्री जो कि हैं मेरी ट्रेनर यास्मीन कराची वाला रुवीना बाटिया फैट फ्री ऑलमोस्ट एंड राशि चौधरी जो एक न्यूट्रिशन एक्सपर्ट हैं दुबई से मैं इन तीनों को जानती हूँ दे बोथ इनक्रेडिबल एट व्हाट दे डू एंड मैं इसलिए यहाँ पे आई हूँ बिकॉज आई रियली बिलीव इन देयर फिलोसफी जो कि है कि आपको अपनी लाइफ स्टाइल चेंज करनी चाहिए यू नीड टू अडॉप्ट अ हेल्दी लाइफ स्टाइल वर्कआउट न्यूट्रिशन ऐसा नहीं है कि आप कुछ भी खा लें कभी भी यू ऑल नो द सेंसिबल आंसर सो आई थिंक इट वॉज रियली इंटरेस्टिंग इट्स मार्च वी जस्ट हैड वुमेन्स डे एंड इट्स अ गुड टाइम टू प्रमोट मोर हेल्थ मोर फिटनेस अमंग्स वुमेन आई थिंक यू नो एवरीबडी जस्ट नीड्स अ लिटिल इंकरेजमेंट अ लिटिल फ्यू वर्ड्स ऑफ एडवाइस शायद पर्सनल एक्सपीरियंस से अगर मैं कुछ शेयर करूँ इफ इट कैन हेल्प एनीबडी देन आई थिंक दैट्स अ गुड थिंग
इतनी बड़ी डिस्कशन के बाद आपने कैसी खाया
जी एक्चुअली मैं तीनों को इतनी अच्छी तरह से जानती हूँ कि ऑलरेडी जितने भी टिप्स ये बता रही हैं मैंने अपनी लाइफस्टाइल में ऑलरेडी अडॉप्ट किए हैं. लेकिन हाँ, जब भी ऐसे मौक़ों पे आते हैं कुछ ना कुछ सीखने को मिलता है, बिकॉज आई थिंक वी लर्न एवरी डे फ्रॉम अदर प्रॉब्लम्स दैट लेडीज़ आर हैविंग और मे बी न्यू रेसिपीज और मे बी न्यू थिंग्स टू ट्राई. दर इज ऑलवेज समथिंग टू लर्न. But yeah, I think the most important thing is ki kisi ko kabhi crash dieting nahi karni chahiye. I don't believe in that. And everybody has to realize ki everybody is unique. You know, jo aap kar sakte hain wo main nahi kar sakti hu, and jo aapke liye acha hai shayad wo mere liye nahi acha. I think that's what people need to realize. And log har cheez mein itna waqt aur paisa invest karte hain. I think maine ek bahut acha example diya ki hum sab log itne obsessed hain apne future ko leke. तो हम हॉरोस्कोप देखते रहते हैं, हम ज्योतिषियों को मिलते हैं, हम उनको पैसे देते हैं, लेकिन अपनी खुद की जो बॉडी है, खुद की जो हेल्थ है, आई थिंक सबसे ज़्यादा उसमें इन्वेस्ट करना चाहिए. दैट्स द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग. जी मेरा नंबर वन सीक्रेट इज़ रियली कंसिस्टेंसी. मैंने कभी ऐसा नहीं किया है कि पागलों की तरह एक हफ़्ता वर्कआउट किया और फिर आराम से बैठ गया, या दो हफ्ते कम्प्लीटली पागलों की तरह डाइट किया एंड देन बैक टू नॉर्मल. जो भी मैं करती हूँ वो कंसिस्टेंट है. इट्स माई लाइफ. इट्स नॉट के हाँ, अगर कोई सॉन्ग शूटिंग होगी तो देन आई पुश माई सेल्फ अ लिटिल बिट मोर. आई हैव ऑलवेज डन दैट. बट क्योंकि मैं कंसिस्टेंट लेवल पे रहती हूँ, इसका ये मतलब नहीं है कि बिफोर अ सॉन्ग शूट आई हैव टू लूज 5 kilos. इट्स प्रॉब्ली 1 kilo बिकॉज आई एम ऑलवेज कंसिस्टेंट. नंबर टू, डोंट डू समथिंग जस्ट बिकॉज समबडी एल्स इज डूइंग इट. दैट्स अ वेरी बिग टिप, बिकॉज आपको लगता है आपकी दोस्त अभी तो आपको भी करना चाहिए, लेकिन शायद वो आपको सूट नहीं करता है. सो यू नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड योर बॉडी एंड वॉट वर्क्स फॉर यू. एंड नंबर थ्री, नेवर स्टार्व योर सेल्फ. अगर आपको लगता है कि खाना बंद करके आप पतले हो जाएंगे, एक्चुअली जो होगा वो उल्टा है. यू विल बिकम फैटर. द ओनली वे टू लूज वेट इज़ टू ईट करेक्टली, एंड बिलीव इट ऑर नॉट यू हैव टू ईट फैट. That doesn't mean eating all yummy desi mithaiyan shadaiyan, nothing like that. Good fats, nuts, coconut oil, avocados, acche fats aapko khane padenge to be able to lose weight. So ha, don't be consistent, don't copy anybody, and don't starve.
जी जितना भी मिलती
जी
कितना बड़ा मिथ है डाइट करने का और कितने गलत
नहीं. एवरीबडी ओनली टॉक्स अबाउट डाइटिंग एंड आई थिंक शायद इसलिए हम वो वर्ड यूज ही नहीं करते. वी डोंट इवन कॉल राशि अ डाइटिशियन, शी इज अ न्यूट्रिशनिस्ट, बिकॉज एक्चुअली इट्स अबाउट टीचिंग योर बॉडी टू ईट करेक्टली. जिस तरह से आप अपने माइंड को सिखाते हैं कि ये सही है या इस चीज़ के बारे में आपको ये सोचना चाहिए, जिस तरह से आप अपने माइंड को एजुकेट करते हैं अबाउट एवरीथिंग इज हैपनिंग इन द वर्ल्ड, like that you have to educate your body about what's good for it. So I think diets ko leke bahut zyada myths hain, kyunki log dusron ko dekhte hain, log sochte hain is actress ne aise kiya, log sochte hain internet pe aisa ho raha hai. People do all kinds of crazy things, but let me tell you, whoever has done an extreme diet, the minute they have stopped it, they've put on twice the amount of weight. Aur phir sochte hain aisa kaise ho gaya. Obviously if you stop eating and then suddenly you start eating, you will put on the weight, which is why the focus is on adopting, I don't want to say a diet, but actually adopting a diet for your life. ऐसा खाना जो आप easily manage कर सकते हो, जो आप रोज़ खाओगे, जिसमें you're not feeling deprived. जैसे ही आप अपने आप को कहोगे I can never ever ever eat a pizza again, you're gonna want the pizza now. So you can't deprive yourself. You have to be sensible. आई थिंक मैं हमेशा पतली ही थी. आई थिंक मैं चबी जो मैं आज बात 12, 13, 14 एंड मोर सो क्योंकि मैं लंदन में पली बढ़ी हूँ और मेरे स्कूल में शायद 3-4 देसी लड़कियाँ थीं, बाकी सब फॉरेनर्स. सो दे वर थिन, दे वर ब्लॉन्ड, दे वर टॉल, दे वर यू नो ऑल ऑफ दैट. सो आई वॉज ऑलवेज दैट. तो दैट्स व्हेन आई फेल्ट. लेकिन सबसे ज़्यादा मुझे लगा कि आई एम बिग इज़ व्हेन आई एक्चुअली मूव टू बॉम्बे. और जब मैंने MTV पे काम करना शुरू किया, आई फाउंड द गर्ल्स इन बॉम्बे वेरी स्किनी, वेरी स्मॉल. और मेरी जिस किस्म की बॉडी है, इट्स मे बी आई डोंट नो, मे बी इट्स जस्ट आई एम मोर कर्वी, आई एम स्लिम, बट आई एम नॉट लाइक अ डंडी. आई नेवर वॉज, एंड आई थिंक द टिपिकल इंडियन बॉडी टाइप इज स्किनी लेग्स एंड अ टमी. And I never had that. I never had the stomach. I had fit legs. I had, you know, a fit body. So when I was on MTV, I always felt that I'm so much larger than everybody. And a few people would comment on it. And that's a very bad headspace to be in because I was fitter than most people. They must have been much skinnier. But they were not as fit as me. So I think the most important lesson to learn is that someone can be half size ho sakta hai, and she can be not fit at all, because all of that weight can only be fat. And whereas you might be heavier, but you have muscle and not fat. So these are all things you have to learn. But MTV ke time pe I used to get up with Cyrus Brochan, and everybody used to say, but you're the hottest, you're the sexiest, you're the most unique. And I think that became my own unique quality, that I was sexy, that I was confident about my body, that I was not like anybody else. Main baaki ladkiyon ki tarah nahi thi, I was different. And I think that that became my asset. And till today, I think I have my own very unique space and main usko maintain kar raha hoon.
Thank you so much.
Anybody else?
No.
That's it.